ba o le gele bo o denodo ke nwani be wale wola ve.
You know, I'm quite an Afrocentric person, and for me, it's a conversation I tend to have with myself often because I come from a country that was at the core of the transatlantic slave trade. Sierra Leone was a huge bastion post for Britain's involvement in the slave trade. And I have different tribal lineages. I'm Timini, I'm Fulani, I'm Ndinka, I'm Soso, I'm Shabro, and many of these tribes, you know, lost. We lost a lot. You know, I think when we talk about loss, you know, there is that conversation that tends to come from the wider diaspora, and rightly so. But we lost. We lost our relatives. We lost land power. We lost empires and principalities. We lost a lot. And I think that, I wouldn't subscribe to a romantic idea of Africa insofar as saying that there would have been unity and we would have all been kings and queens. And but I think that we would have been stable for a very long time. Africa, in spite of our warring, there was a great sense of stability. We had empires, and a lot of people don't realize that at the fall of empire came the rise of the slave trade. So you can, you know, if we look into history, we see how well developed many African, particularly West African nations were. I mean, a lot of people subscribe to Mansa Musa, for example, and how rich he was and how developed he was. Even where I come from, we had the first West African university and institution. So, you know, I think Africa's always been the helm of education and advancement, and I think that we have lost a great deal. But I think that if we take from the past those things that are sacred for us and we disseminate that amongst our children within the diaspora, then I think that there is a greater sense of, or a greater hope that we can be where we need to be, and we can move towards that. That's what I think can happen.